insights from the world's best medical minds. You are watching TheRightDoctors.com.
Dr. Bhandari is an experienced physician and diabetologist and also a fellow of Royal College of Physicians, London and Edinburgh. Dr. Bhandari has a unique distinction of being honorary physician to His Excellency, the Governors of Rajasthan.
Dr. Sudhir Bhandari, congratulations on the management of patients of COVID-19. I believe you have successfully treated two COVID-19...
Three
COVID-19 yes, positive patients. I think there was a couple of Italian patients.
Yes.
Yeah. Can you please, because everybody wants to know how you manage. So can you please elaborate what treatment was given to these patients?
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Pareek. It's a pleasure talking to you. I represent one of the biggest, the pioneer institute of Asia, SMS Medical College Institute. We were well aware of that the corona issue is, COVID issue is happening all around. So we were very sensitized. If you recollect, we had the great experience of handling swine flu epidemic 7-8 years before.
Yeah.
And we have been getting a lot of cases of swine flu, all the terminal respiratory pneumonia patients.
Yeah.
So when we were prepared for this, much before the first patient came, we had studied, we have a core team of consultants in SMS Medical College. We studied a lot of literature, we checked up a lot of trials, etc. And when these first three patients, one Italian couple and a elderly or Indian person from Dubai came, second and third were the senior citizen with high risk group.
Okay.
The second was a 69-year-old Italian with the emphysema. Third was an 85-year-old Indian with a renal failure.
Okay.
So it was a real challenge with us.
Yeah,
we checked up the literature, and whenever a COVID patient comes, you know, it requires intense medical management, intense supportive management, and definitely we had to work upon anything which we can do to reduce the viral replication and to reduce the virus load. So the moment these patients came, they were corona positive, tested twice. They had significant medical issues of breathlessness, high fever, respiratory distress, etc., etc. Then along with the standard medical management, the supportive treatment, we started working on the antiviral drug. All our bottom line was to reduce viral load. Having seen a lot of literature for chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine, a lot of trials which were going on to have antiviral effect, along with the two of the antiviral drugs, that is lopinavir as well as ritonavir. So we started using a combination of hydroxychloroquine, which we gave for 5 days, and then we coupled up this with the lopinavir and ritonavir. We made a protocol. All these patients, we had taken the consent, we started this protocol, and we were monitoring the side effect, if at all any.
So they were introduced a day after, or how soon they were introduced?
No, the moment they tested positive.
Okay.
Because there is a definite indication of giving antiviral drugs, because they were significantly symptomatic. That's a reason, because they were symptomatic, saturation was little compromised, breathlessness was there. So the moment second sample confirmed that they are corona positive, we introduced this combination of three drugs.
I believe you consulted ICMR also for treating this patient. Is there any guideline to practitioners from ICMR on this?
Yes. In fact, what happened coincidentally, the ICMR team happened to be in our institute same day. So we discussed with the ICMR that we, in intention to reduce the viral load, and we want to use this protocol, and probably it was consented by them.
Okay.
So we use hydroxychloroquine coupled up with the lopinavir and ritonavir. Yeah.
So what is the benchmark to consider if the patient has been treated successfully?
Now,
Does it require repeated testing, or how long
be followed? I'll tell you, what do we do? It was our initial experience. So we were closely monitoring if at all any side effect, which was not there. Day one, along with this treatment and other supportive treatment, patient starts improving. The first patient, lady who was 50 plus, became corona negative within 7 days.
Yeah.
Two successful testing were required to label a corona negative.
Mm-hmm.
The second patient, who was an advanced cardiac patient and COPD patient because of being a chain smoker. He also became corona negative in next 10 days. And the best ward, we had a third patient who was a senior citizen, 85-year-old man with a renal failure, became corona negative. And all the three patients we discharged happily. So if I couple up their sequence of recovery, the sense of well-being, no side effect, I have a feeling that along with the giving standard medical treatment, we need to act in a direction to reduce virus load. We need to reduce the viremia, and this will be documented by fast recovery as well as corona being negative. Now we have got six more patients positive with us. It is a very beginning of our experience. We have put on the same regime. We started hydroxychloroquine and we put on antiviral. If there are some, all of six have given consent to be given. Suppose we come across any person who has not been put on this regime. So shorter duration of the person on regime to be corona negative, faster the recovery, better being the respiratory symptoms, clearing of the pneumonia patch on X-ray, improvement of the oxygen saturation, requiring lesser of oxygen and lesser of BiPAP support. So I'm sure over the period of time, all these parameters are going to make our conviction stronger that yes, we should be able to reduce the virus load by using these newer drugs.
There is a study from China where chloroquine has been used and it improved the pneumonia. And there is a study from France where they have used hydroxychloroquine
with azithromycin.
So what is your view?
Let me tell you, in fact, we checked up a lot of literature. The chloroquine was used in SARS and MERS also. And because of the toxicity of these viruses, there was every valid reason that we could use this chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine in our patients. Similar study, although it was a short study from France with 26 patients only, but this study clear-cut mentions that in the people whom they gave chloroquine and azithromycin, the patient's recovery was much faster and the patient became corona negative and recovery was much faster. We, I think we look what studies, more number of patients to be looked into this perspective. Although we don't want more patients to come, but let me tell you one thing, we have been following this protocol and as the we are entering the phase 3, we started getting some more patients. So, you know, when the endeavor of making patient feel better, in the endeavor of making they recover faster to reduce the morbidity and mortality, we have been giving this combination of chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine coupled up with the lopinavir. Even we won't mind in a mildly symptomatic patient to give only hydroxychloroquine or chloroquine coupled up with azithromycin. And could be a patient has significant symptom, we could combine later the newer antiviral drugs, which are very safe. So I think over the period of time, once we try our combination in more and more patients, but preliminary observations has been, it is worth giving a trial to these patients because we have got all positive results and seeing the patient recover faster.
I think there is an in vitro study which says that hydroxychloroquine, since it is little longer half-life plus better concentration in the respiratory secretions may be preferable. But that's in vitro data.
No, let me tell you one thing. Even then, in vitro data is worth considering. More important is that the toxicity of hydroxychloroquine is much lesser and it is dose-dependent.
Yeah, it's better tolerated.
So it is better tolerated. Yeah. I have a feeling we need to take into consideration the in vitro study definitely. But equally important is the lesser toxicity and it is a dose-dependent toxicity of hydroxychloroquine. So the level of confidence of using hydroxychloroquine is much more than a simple chloroquine. And I think we... another thing is that, you know, I have been a part of hydroxychloroquine as an anti-inflammatory in diabetes, very positive results. We have been using hydroxychloroquine in a number of other conditions. I have a feeling that having used even for longer and longer duration, the toxicity is very less and late. So I have a kind of confidence that in a short duration, which we are aiming here, shouldn't be any problem.
I think you have been part of our clinical studies as well, and you have used hydroxychloroquine in many patients. So your experience becomes very important. What is your advice to uncontrolled diabetes patients, whether the diabetes is a
In fact, anti-inflammatory role in so far we have been addressing all the etiologies of diabetes also, but this anti-inflammatory role of hydroxychloroquine, and I was an integral part of it. Having wonderful results, it has been an integral part of my anti-diabetic treatment. To be honest, there are so many strengths of hydroxychloroquine. It is economical. It has lesser toxicity because the dose related. It brings about a very good diabetic control and reduces the insulin sensitivity. And it increases the insulin sensitivity and reduces the insulin resistance. So I feel it has a proven anti-inflammatory advantageous effect in these metabolic diseases also. So I think this antiviral effect need to be considered with very practically very low toxicity profile.
So another very important issue is that how a practitioner should deal with this. What is the current situation in Rajasthan?
Now, there is a
peer community spread. What measures should be undertaken to prevent
this? First of all, I must tell you, we are entering the phase 3 of corona spread. Yes. So far, this COVID-19 had come from the international travelers who had come from identified countries and some of the people who came in international travelers. Okay. Now, we are fearing the interpersonal or community spread. I have a feeling the way our government is proactive, way the Honorable Prime Minister has been motivating everything. We are lucky to be in this country. Yeah. I have a feeling that if each and every citizen of our country follows these basic principles of total isolation for next 2 to 3 weeks, following the principles of frequent hand washing, following the principles of preventing the congregation, following the principle of not going into public places, and I think it is a moral responsibility of all of us to prevent the interpersonal community spread. Now, if you look at the other countries also, first 3 weeks was almost a flat curve. Fourth and fifth week, it zoomed up like anything. So I think we keep our finger crossed. I have an appeal to all my fellow Indians, fellow colleagues, that please maintain quarantine. Especially, I would strongly appeal to my senior citizen colleagues who have diabetes, who have hypertension, who have kidney problem, who are immunocompromised, who are a COPD patient on steroids or inhalers, and for any other reason, they have a low immune status. Probably they need to keep themselves away, keep taking all the measures of hand wash, all the measures of preventing the virus.
High-risk group which you mentioned, besides isolation, do you recommend any prophylaxis to these
people? Yes. To be honest, there has been a lot of few studies of prophylaxis with, again, the hydroxychloroquine.
Yeah.
But I would wait for some more time for having definite value for this prophylactic proposal. I would like, let the authenticated journal, like New England Journal or Lancet, theoretically, I would say sooner or later it will be included in prophylactic armamentarium. But you know, we stay in such a country that there has to be a rock solid evidence for any advice. Otherwise, little misuse or overuse of any prophylactic medication will be very detrimental. So I would recommend for my general practitioner colleagues and doctors that if we suspect COVID manifestation, if someone has a travel history, contact history, and now even without history, because we are entering in phase 3, if someone has fever, cough, cold, and suspected symptoms, it will be better to meet in a consultant, better to think in direction of that. And now the new ICMR guideline says that any person who has a respiratory symptom with or without contact need to be tested for COVID-19.
And the moment, very important thing which you are saying, I think.
New ICMR guidelines are, any person who has cough, cold, fever, even without contact with the suspect or contact with the patient, need to get himself investigated, because we have started having community cases. So if you are COVID positive, then I would still feel hydroxychloroquine is a great drug to begin in mild patient. With the newer studies, we may combine with azithromycin, which is again a harmless drug. And in the moderate and the severe symptoms, or if there's a patch of pneumonia on x-ray, or there's a falling oxygen saturation, falling blood pressure, there's a tachypnea, breath, general condition is low, I think we can club hydroxychloroquine with antiviral therapy, and which is very safe, very well effective, like lopinavir and ritonavir. So I'm sure, I must thank Dr. Pareek. I think your dedication, Dr. Anil Pareek, your research of hydroxychloroquine is helping us, and I think helping country and helping world. All compliments to you, Dr. Anil Pareek.
Thank you, sir. So finally, what is your advice to practitioners in rural areas?
My advice to practitioners in rural area will be twofold, Dr. Anil. First advice, in a present situation of
COVID-19,
in a present situation, my dear doctor colleagues, that we have to protect our country from entering into phase 3, that is ensure complete isolation. Don't see non-critical patients. This, if at all you see any critical patient with respiratory symptom, better you protect yourself using N95. N95 mask is not essential for public at large. I must clarify, there's been a rat race of acquiring N95 masks by public, which is not required. So it should be N95 mask for doctors only.
I think this is a very important advice for our rural colleagues.
Yeah. So rural colleagues, that please educate people. Simple 3-layer surgical mask is enough if someone is coughing. Otherwise, for a common population, I again repeat, there is no need of mask. Maintain a distance of 5 to 6 feet from any person whom you are talking to or who you are interacting. A normal person doesn't require any mask. If someone has a cough, cold, sneezing, he can use a mask, triple layer, and N95 is only for medics, paramedics, or consultant who see a patient. Second, one of the most important thing I must share with you, that this virus gets, when someone coughs or someone sneezes, this virus settles down on any of the surfaces. So frequent hand washings are very, very important.
Yes.
One important advice I like to give you, my rural colleague, that the first station when this virus enters the body, it is your throat mucosal lining and the mucosal lining of sinuses where the virus grows. So if you can take warm water few times a day, and you can take a steam inhalation through your nose and mouth few times a day or after exposure, you deactivate, or it will help you to deactivate virus. So I would strongly recommend my colleagues and my countrymen in rural area to drink warm water, to take steam, etc. Not to worry about the mask, maintain a distance, frequent hand washing. This is more valid for senior citizen, and total isolation or quarantine in home for next 3 weeks. Now, if someone develops the symptoms, my doctor colleagues in rural area, what you should do is that if the patient has a cough, patient has a fever, patient has little breathlessness, make sure you can, if you are confident, fine. Otherwise, consult with a higher center or a senior consultant. Get him examined for the COVID-19, which is a new ICMR guidelines to test everyone with a suspected respiratory symptom. And moment you find, it will be logical and prudent to start hydroxychloroquine, may combine azithromycin in mild cases.
Thank you.
Moderate cases, yeah, you can combine antiviral drugs.
Thank you, Dr. Sudhir. It's a pleasure talking to you. I hope listening to this podcast will give the practitioner some insight on managing suspected COVID-19 cases. Thank
you. My pleasure.
Thanks a lot, sir.
So nice of you. Thank you, Dr. Pareek.
You are listening to a special podcast on unfolding coronavirus pandemic on India's leading medical knowledge platform, TheRightDoctors.com. I am Dr. Anil Pareek, and we'll be back with another thought leader from the medical fraternity in our next episode. Till then, stay safe, maintain your social distance, and make sure you and your staff and your patients practice the do's and don'ts as set out by the WHO and the Ministry of Health India. Goodbye for now. Take care.
Insights from the world's best medical minds. You are watching TheRightDoctors.com.